Thank you, Sally. Well, in this weekend's Arts Avenue, today we are learning about the Latino Arts String Program. And to talk more about it, I'm joined now by Denora Marquez. Denora, thanks so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you for having me back.
So I know that you've been here before, and it's always fascinating to hear about the program and what it is. But for those of us, or for those out there, I should say, who missed last segment when you were on before, can you just give a general sense for what you guys are all about?
Well, the Latino Arts Strings Program is a scholarship-based program in the Latino community that provides low-income Latino youth with everything they need to prepare to play a classical string instrument. Mm-hmm. And so everything's a scholarship, private lessons, small group lessons, instruments, materials, everything they would need to be able to succeed in that very difficult area of classical music.
Now you guys have just celebrated your 10-year, or are getting ready to celebrate your 10-year anniversary. Do I understand
yes,
that right?
Yes, that's correct. This is our 10th year of excellence in music training. We're very excited about it, in great part because we have support from local organizations like UPAF, so we're very grateful for that. Part of the celebration is the whole year we're going to have a whole series of celebrations, and some of those are coming up.
I know one of them that's coming up we're going to get to in just a moment. Before we do, though, let's talk about an award that you guys won recently.
Yes, we were very fortunate. We were one of five organizations across the country to receive the MetLife After School Innovators Award. And we just celebrated that last week, and we had folks from Washington, D.C. come in to give us the award and to celebrate with us.
Oh, congratulations.
That's
quite an honor and well-deserved. Now let's talk about one of the upcoming events, and that is the Day of the Dead concert. Let's kind of describe for folks out there what that's all about.
Well, we're celebrating Day of the Dead. I think it's becoming much more common now. People know what it's about. And it's going to be at the Latino Arts Auditorium. And we have a concert with alongside two-time Grammy Award nominee Renato Cerón, whose group is called Flor de Piel. And so our Mariachi Juvenil will be opening for them and playing with them. So it's very exciting. And then along with that, we have the ofrendas, which are the altars, the Day of the Dead altars at our gallery, and a lot of other wonderful things and surprises that
Let's
night.
Put the information up on the screen so that people can see exactly where they can head out there if they want to check it out. This is the Day of the Dead celebration, Friday, November 2nd. There's more information on WISN.com. Off the top of your head, do you know what time this gets started?
The concert will be at 7:30, but the opening of the gallery will be since 5 in the evening, so people can come and have dinner at Cafe Sol, go to the gallery, go to a concert. It's an all-evening thing. They'd
yeah.
love it.
Yeah, you can, as you say, make an evening of it. And real quick, let's also let people know where.
It'll be at the 1029 South 9th Street, which is the United Community Center address.
Okay. Denora, thanks so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you, Abe. Thank you very much.